Even though she's been dealing with asthma since she was 12, Jody Moore says it's never been as bad as when she was expecting her daughters.
It was way worse when I was pregnant. Yeah, it was worse than it had ever been, ever.
The fact that Jody's asthma flared to dangerous levels when she was pregnant is obviously a uniquely female experience. But when it comes to asthma, it may not be the only one.
Asthma in men and women is not the same. There's this general perception that, you know, one size fits all for asthma, but we have found that actually that's not the case.
Dr. Jennifer McAllister is an asthma expert at Ohio State University Medical Center who is calling for a new sex-specific approach to asthma. McAllister says there is growing evidence that the same disease can affect men and women in very different ways. For example, under the age of 15, asthma is 54% more common in males. But after the age of 35, that changes. Asthma becomes nearly twice as common in women. Females are also more likely to be hospitalized from asthma and are more likely to die from it. Studies show they even report different symptoms, which could impact how their doctors choose to treat them.
By using sex-specific symptoms, then you may be better able to determine just how well controlled a patient's asthma is.
There are enough differences in men and women that many are now calling for the same thing, a new gender-specific approach to studying and treating asthma, not only for patients now, but for future generations as well. At Ohio State University Medical Center, this is Clark Powell reporting.